Seven of our greatest athletes have been inducted into the Sports Australia Hall of Fame today. They include Socceroo Tim Cahill, Olympic gold medal skier Lydia Lasilla, and NRL legend Johnathan Thurston, world champion surfer Lane Beachley, former Wallabies captain Mark Eller, and triple Brownlow medalist Bob Skilton been elevated to legend status. We have a couple of Aussie icons in the shop there right now. It's Johnathan Thurston! Hey, JT, you're now alongside sporting icons like Sir Don Bradman and Cathy Freeman. How does that feel?
Yeah, it's extremely humbling. I couldn't believe it when they rang and, was telling me that I was going to be inducted into the Sports Australia Hall of Fame. So, I had to do a second take. I thought it was a G-up. But, extremely proud. As you mentioned, those two people there and the rest of the sporting icons that are in the Hall of Fame, they've change their sport nationally or globally, and to have my name alongside these people is truly humbling and a proud moment.
JT, quickly, I've always wanted to know, what does the Sports Hall of Fame locker room smell like? There's some,
ew.
Is there a pong?
we had the function here today down at the Rock, so we're in a flash joint. So, boy that was born in Brisbane and raised, and to be down here with the other inductees that got into the Hall of Fame as well was a special day. So, it's certainly a day I will not forget, and just a real proud and humbling feeling.
Thursto, Liz Ellis was telling us here in the desk recently that the Hall of Fame Awards, it's like a massive party. Everyone gets together. Now, you're an NRL player, which would put you at the top of all sporting partiers. Like, by that, how did you go today? Did you rip in?
No, I didn't rip in. I'm actually got a couple of nights away with the wife. So.
Oh, OK, right. Oh, wow. Romance is not there.
Yes.
Johnathan, it's a well-deserved award. I mean, moments like this, I guess, tend to make you reflective on your career. Have you had a couple of moments today when you've thought back about your own career and what stands out for you?
Yeah, probably the 2015 Grand Finals, number one. Being a part of the first ever Cowboys Premiership team is something I'm proud of, and to work with your best mates to get that job done, and to see what it meant to the people of North Queensland. Taking that trophy all through to those Indigenous communities all around the north and seeing the smiles it put on their faces is something I'll never forget. So that's it. And probably the eight in a row.
Yeah.
Oh, I have to bring that up.
Pretty good
hell?
As well. So that's always a good feeling.
See, he's got to look around when he says that, though, just in case there are any blues.
I noticed it was also number two because it was probably a bit easy. Yeah. Hey, this is obviously a legacy moment, right? And you're being recognised for your legacy. Hard question for you to answer, but try to be as objective as you can. What do you see as your legacy on the game? Like, what have you left behind, you reckon?
I haven't actually thought about that. I was very lucky. I wouldn't say lucky, but I was had to work extremely hard to get my opportunity in the NRL and got an opportunity with the Bulldogs, and then wanted to play more first grade, so went to the Cowboys, and then obviously that 2015 Grand Final was, that's my number one. I'm not too sure of the legacy, but, rugby league doesn't define who I am as a person. I'm much more than just a rugby league player. And I've got the Johnathan Thurston Academy as well, which is doing some wonderful things in the community up in the north. So, very proud to have, rugby league's given me that opportunity to help create social change, but it certainly doesn't define who I am. It's been a big part of my life, and I wouldn't be where I am without that. But, I've been able to go on and achieve other things in my life as well.
Hey, look, we kind of have to acknowledge we're speaking at this moment. It's a great celebration for you. It is the aftermath of the referendum. I know you were on the yes side of that. You campaigned for it. So you're obviously disappointed in that way. I kind of don't know whether we should give you the opportunity to comment because of this moment or precisely because of this moment you don't want to. And you just don't think this is the moment really or the time for you to say anything. I'm going to leave it in your hands, mate. Do you want to say anything about it?
Yeah, look, I supported The Voice. I work closely in these Indigenous communities and see the struggles that they have personally. Some of these kids can't go to school because there's no running water. Like, that's totally unacceptable in this day and age. And whilst that problem has been fixed since we raised that issue, I thought there was a great opportunity for us to unite Australians and acknowledge the oldest living culture that's been here for 60,000 years. So it is a sad day in my eyes for Australia, but that's not going to stop what I continue to do, and that is to help inspire the next generation of our culture that are still dying 8 years younger than the rest of our nation, that are still more incarcerated than the rest of our nation, and certainly are living in conditions and going to school in conditions that are like third world conditions. So yeah, like I said, I thought it was an opportunity to unite Australia, but whilst I respect what the Australian nation has voted on, I don't agree with it, but I will certainly continue to fight for our kids. I thought it was a great opportunity for us to unite.
Johnathan Thurston, you're an incredible bloke. We appreciate your time. Congrats on making it into the Hall of Fame. You don't need an award, though. You're a legend anyway. See you soon.
Thank you for having me.